Chris, you have keys to the locker.
I don't have keys, but if you go upstairs, Nicholas is in the office.
Oscar.
Don't know if he has keys to get into the locker. Nicholas is upstairs, and he has keys.
Which did you see as a game?
think he was an up tempo in the session. No, what would you? I thought it was a bit slow to get that. I think the race, the passing race, if you want to do like these passing patterns, I think if you can find a way to get them to start quicker and then get them into them competitions, is actually they probably did it at the tempo we were hoping. Yeah, I think it's maybe known these guys a bit more, but they like the competition, they like the tempo, they like working hard. It's kind of working hard. I'm not saying it's like you or anything, but it does motivate them. It's kind of like a way to like get into them.
I'm not going to do it, but it's implement some patterns.
On that one, I filmed one circuit, I'll send you it. I filmed Dan Skin was the first player to take it. I filmed it. It took 2 minutes 30 for him to get
it. Yeah. Which usually I do that with less players. With you.
Yeah. So yeah. So with that in mind, it's like if I'm shooting, how do we get more repetitions of the shooting?
It's meant for it,
Yeah. It's just something to consider. It's like again the motivation of the boys, because we are 12 and 13. It's like how do we get like a little bit more opposition and decision making and then like the repetition. I think probably in the like I understand tomorrow's the game. I guess some of the stuff was around is going to be tomorrow. But if we think of like the boys themselves, they like competition, if we think about skill development, really it's like developing under some, making decisions under pressure. What we're trying to do is like this game based on good things. Almost the decision comes first, so they know what they're looking for, they know what they're trying to see, and then you manipulate time and space and pressure. Because we want to work with skills that way, like in the approach. So it's just about maybe thinking that way. Like I said, I think it's going to be a passing plan to get the game in, because you could see the boys' move change. I know even the wall pass in the race. And it should have got worse because of the time pressure, but it improved their motivation, like lifted. So it might, if you want like that tempo and get them repetitions up, it might be something to think about how you make these passing patterns more race like.
I think it's not like anywhere I want, but also that's what I understand.
Yeah, because I think you'll feel it with living in Spain. People do feel it slower here. So it's worth finding ways to like constantly increase the tempo, and I think you might have found it with the races. So however you do, like get into that race quicker.
I think
if you can get it in simple, you can basically have like one practice of it, or two practices. They know what you're looking for from a skill coaching perspective, so like how you kick the ball, whatever. And then get them into the race, because they really, you could see their faces lift, you could see them enjoy it. And
I think they
And like the 13-year-old boys, they don't care so much about the fine detail. They don't want to walk through things too much. They want to, they basically want to like have a go at it and keep going.
Yeah, they want to play and compete.
Yeah, yeah. And if you can maybe think about like them details that you have, I think the assessment of the players has been pretty correct so far. But if you can find a way of getting them details and
keep. Right, so 0-0.
Yes, 0-0. It's only just started. 2-3 minutes. If you can find a way of getting them details in game base, I think you'll really grab the players.
Yeah, I mean, in my experience, the floor of
the
crowd.
Yeah.
I took several hours and I wanted.
But like what you gotta consider, a bit of background on this team. The culture has been from day one to be like high tempo. There's not been so much specific technical detail and tactical which you might have noticed, but they've definitely been used to working hard and a lot at this tempo level, so they really enjoy that. And the culture of the group enjoy it. The ones who kind of have stayed in the group enjoy it. So now there's like a bit of a change, but they will benefit. And I think you'll get something from them, you'll get an energy from them because they are enjoying that.
What's the score?
0-0.
Oh.
And
for a few, you know, they're lacking to change.
Oh, for sure. And then you know better than me, right?
Yeah. So I have to also be very careful in introducing loaded with new information. They don't feel that I'm taking away from them what they have been doing like pretty much for the last 6 months.
And also you're dealing with parents as well.
Oh,
so like that, they're the same. I think if you can get that game first feel, and then introduce these ideas. But also we've got pre-match tomorrow, half-time, post-match to also teach. And during the game, there's going to be some things that happen that are significant that you're going to want to instruct straight away. Deeper, wider, faster, higher, longer, whatever you're looking for. You're going to want to bring that in, right? So that these are all coaching moments for sure.
I don't like to be like giving information all the time because I think that's also really for them. But definitely like some basics. And now that they're
but it's like essential stuff. So the way I would see it is like you've got to give them urgent information and essential information, and that's like responsibility to code. And then once you start creating that, you can ask questions, you can observe, you can leave them. But like these are the little boys who need to be clear on what it is you want from them. Because you're brand new to them. You're brand new, so it's like the expectations have to be laid out to everybody, especially in Finland.
And I wanted to
Yeah.
But apparently we have this problem that we can't. So it was not about being healthy. So it's about the second. Niklas said that. I will talk to the kids tomorrow about the technology thing that I would think something that they would probably.
But what you could do, if they've got the link for the game, just send them the timestamp. So basically just say, hey, look at like 15 minutes 36, look for this and this.
I was planning to highlight like three big issues the game.
Yeah, I mean if you could maybe turn that from like three big issues to two big issues plus a positive from something, that might just like lift the boys, because they took a slip in last week, like, you know, let's be honest, it was some bad stuff. And these are boys who've like in the second year Ukinen and like the fourth and Kakinen last year, they were very at the top end of all these leagues, and they've taken taking a bit of a paste into it.
Yeah, yeah, so that is normal.
Oh, yeah, yeah, yeah. We, this is new for us. There's not many of these kids who I think have all the good things. This is where they used to they need to know about. They need to know the whole process. Yeah,
they were bigger and stronger and bigger.
They need to know. They know. They need to know. It's going to be a lot of football, right? So things happen. If you've got a quick forward, you're in trouble. if you're not pressing and controlling the space, you're in trouble. If you're not moving the ball well enough, you can't run the whole distance that you play. This is the learning curve. But we should use the game as a teaching experience.
I'm kind of worried, to be honest with you, because I've been through that in the previous season. And even if you know what to say, we didn't start really well, but then
it doesn't bother me so much either, but it does bother them.
Yeah, of course, they have no patience.
No, absolutely. Yeah. It's not that I necessarily had over it. It's not that I need fairly pressure down or anything. Kids just get it from the ground. And it's basically because of how high the chair is. If they're scared about the feet, then they really
need to do it. But it's also part of the mindset. They don't worry so much about it. They know they're but at the same time, the way they play, the way they develop, which is, even if they work for it.
No, I understand, and I understand exactly where you're going from. But from my perspective, the kids' league is a big problem.
So
we have to find a way to manage it.
The middle ground, right?
Yeah.
But then, of course, then you have the problem that you know, in some cases, then coaches, what I have seen here, is that they don't get playing time for me.
No, but that's because they're not
focused on winning.
No. And we still stick with the 50%. But yeah. if we can still, because basically I'm happy to have that argument with any parents.
Mm-hmm. If you played John and you lost the game, I'll say, well, I'll tell you what, you need to go up there, so you need to win 50,
and then their attitude changes.
And they
so I don't mind the playing time thing. I'll never have a problem with it. If it turn out not to be good enough, then we'll have a discussion with the parents about that. But they'll all get a weakness for 50% minimum.
Unless you like time.
Yeah, we have to like scratch the surface of that, because I spoke to the dad during the week and it turns out that he did inform everybody that he was very good in the world. And I think, well, it was informed that he's not working, it's important. If he's not informed anybody, he's not Yeah, but
he's beating another
team. No, but you're both beating him.
They don't have to block it.
Not the boys,
yeah.
Yeah, you should have been in part. I don't know why you haven't been concerned from that. Yeah, disappointing. No, it is if you can't be there.
If I can't be here, then I'm not going to see the changes. I'm not going to see the changes where we have part of
the world. You certainly will, but you want to be there and you want to be part of the whole process. You're not doing this. It's not something you're doing just for a little bit of fun. You want to help develop the ball, right?
And this is what I told you, like, if I sign up for something, I get the ball.
Yes.
And maybe the level is not super high. But this is all I want to do things the right way.
It's you, can it? It's took, and then we can, these boys can develop. We just have to push them a bit harder, faster, think about it more. But of course, you're in for the long haul, you're in for the real deal, so it needs to be communicated. And it's disappointing that it's surprising how they're communicating to see if these days change up.
I think we can appreciate how.
Unless you can put things on.
Well, that, you know, that's down to you guys, you burn the door, but I also think it's in my bed because I don't know what people are having to do. I think it's you, you do it. I don't really know who can talk to it.
You know, the team leadership, that's like a team decision. Because basically what happens, Nicholas makes the schedule, and then the team leaders get it, and the coaches get it and say, well, like, for example, you guys, you've got two part-time coaches and off people. It's like, hey, well, I work on a Tuesday, for example, a Tuesday, I definitely start here. The kids are all at school until 5. And then, like, they change it and say, can we... But that should be a communication between all the coaches and staff. But the game's getting played tomorrow as well, so yeah, Lowry's dad's already asked him. We also had tactics for them as well, whiteboards.
I have
some great stuff. Make sure you use that and keep trying to just make sure guys understand what it is you're trying to get out of it. Use your free map, use half time to educate. It's an opportunity. It's always another opportunity to do it. Use tomorrow as an opportunity to like get them to like a real clear way, get them to understand some of the to get them to understand what you've been trying to get them to do, and really rally them. Like I know the group a little bit. They really like. I don't think it's good long term, but they might just like lift them with you and get them going on to the last week and stuff. I know it's good from the parents, both of them, it's different. But I think everyone just needs to get a big surge of positivity because they're so used to winning.
Yeah,
they just need to find it. They just need to make it
Yeah.
It was the same in Latin America. They had three boys who were doing away. I understand it. I'm not sure about managing the last bit. yeah, then there's tomorrow. I'm, no, I'm not so much tomorrow. It's more about just getting
but we have the next event at Capcom for us, so
well, we have to get in and find a way. Like, I took the a few more times than that, so I think as long as if we concentrate and get them going, maybe that's how we can surprise some people. I don't want to tell you too much, but he's not a defender. He makes some good tackles. No, but yeah, so why is he playing right back when he's like in the first place? Billy can play right back, centre back, top right. Yeah, Cuckoo should probably play with Cuckoo for me. It's surprising he plays a new game. I just need more of a centre back. You just have to go from a super positive angle. It seems to be the only way to try and get people on board. Because we are so cautious and nervous about the pressure. For some of them, it's like, it's still unfortunate at this age, your parents make a choice. Go home, get going. Go and see your daughter.
Yeah.